Man, we at the premiere of Trying to Do Right, the movie. Our first motion picture duet, myself and writer, director Ron Williams. Mm. You know, my business partner, Merlin. If it weren't for him, man, he bought it out me, dog. Mm. Better come get involved, because we just trying to do right.
Coming into this film, man, when you first thought about making this film, was this always your direction, or?
To be honest with you, I didn't go into this to make this film. My business partner and the writer of this film knows me personally as my character, and he dug and found these people within his writing and say, hey, let's see if you can do it, you know, and we did it. Mm. You seen the movie?
Yeah. This is one thing too, man. Like I seen you had a lot of locations on the movie or whatever, man. Well, did you have any problems when it came to getting those different locations?
No, to be honest with you, man, we had consent forms for everything, for every brand, for every place that we was at. We went and we physically grounded out and did it.
Oh, okay. Like,
you know, ain't nothing better than door-to-door service. We went and got that money.
Comedy, man, but if you was to turn on the radio right now,
right,
you would hear you all through the radio.
Nissan.
How did that situation come about, man? And I think that's like a long time relationship in your head.
Yeah, I've been doing that since like 2003. Mm. I interned with a radio station called Hot 102.1. It's, you know, it's folded now, but that was through Paris Brown, the program director. I had that opportunity to do something for Dan Bannister, and I kept going. And, you know, I'm creative with that. They like me with that. It's real easy. Wanna swap keys.
Definitely. Yeah, man, look. There's a lot of people, when you look, nowadays, when you turn on the radio, even with the Black Beatles freestyle.
Right.
When I heard, sometimes you hear that, you might be thinking of the original version coming on.
And then
your version come
That's
on.
That's how I catch them. That's like a part of my marketing strategy. Especially to market myself, like, because I get to tag myself at the end of it, Banknote. You know, so other than, you know, it's just a different way of marketing, you know, myself and for, corporate company.
Okay. Last question before I get out of here, man. Over the course of maybe a few years that I've been seeing you do the different not concerts, but the different comedy shows.
Right.
Why is it that you feel it's important to make a lot of those shows free?
To be honest with you, because at the timing of, you know, success, you can't, you know, base your success based on money in my eyes. So actually I try to build a fan base first for free. And then, you know, until I can no longer let you in for free, will I charge you? You know, but I mean, I feel like the people is who make us, so that's why it's free.
No,
it's like trying to do right. This premiere today was free for everybody, correct? You see, right?
Yeah.
Free. But, you know, we put our money up and we're gonna reap it back eventually, and it only gotta be for my own people. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So we'll get it back eventually. He, man, who else, man? This is real life, man. The media is no doubt, man. Gordon really keep it. Man, he just trying to do right. But look, man, I appreciate it for real, because y'all gotta keep your eye out. Watch me, watch for the movie Trying to Do Right. Summer 2017. Chris Patterson, my name on social media. Instagram is at Banknote Comedy. Snapchat at Banknote Comedy. Twitter at Banknote Comedy. That's BANKNOTE Comedy, all one word. And I'm a holler.
That's what it is, man.
Appreciate you, brother.
Yep.